In this video from IT Free Training, I will look at a feature in Windows Server 2008 called Universal Group Membership Caching. If you are using Universal Groups in your organization, a global catalog server will be required in order for a user to log in to the network. Universal Groups are available in every domain in the forest and thus need to be replicated via the global catalog server. If Universal Groups are being used and a global catalog server is not available, the following will occur. If the user was the last one to log in to that computer, then the user's credentials may be cached on that computer. If this is the case, the user will be able to log in locally to the computer using the cached credentials. Cached credentials are what allow you to log into your laptop when you disconnect it from the network. This will allow the user to access the local system. But when you attempt to access a resource on the network, like a file share, the server will check the authentication of the user. In order for the server to do this when Universal Groups are being used, it requires access to a global catalog server. If no global catalog servers are available, the connection will be denied. A server will always double-check each connection before it is allowed access. This is done to ensure the user has not been disabled or the account is locked. You may be thinking, could Windows provide access to everything except what was specified in the Universal Groups? The problem with this approach is that the Universal Group could be used to deny a user access to a resource. For this reason, Windows takes the safe bet by denying the user access until it can check the user against a global catalog server. Whenever possible, I would recommend making all domain controllers global catalog servers. But in some cases, replication may be an issue, and this is not possible. For example, if you had three users separated from the main network by a slow, unreliable network connection, it is not worth having all the extra global catalog traffic traveling over the unreliable connection. On a small network, this may not be that noticeable. But in a multi-domain environment with a lot of users, there is not that much benefit to all that extra replication for three users. The problem with this approach when you are using Universal Groups and the network is down is that users on that part of the network may have a problem logging in and accessing servers without a global catalog server. To get around this, you can enable Universal Membership Caching on the domain controller. When you enable Universal Membership Caching, the following happens. When a user logs in to that domain controller, the domain controller will contact a global catalog in order to obtain the Universal Group information. Once the Universal Group's information is obtained, it is stored on that domain controller indefinitely. This will ensure that as long as the user logs into the domain controller when a global catalog server was available to obtain the Universal Group information, the user will always be able to log in regardless of whether a global catalog server was available or not. If a global catalog server is not available when required, the domain controller will simply use the information in the cache. The cached information will only be used if a global catalog server is not available. It is not designed to speed up performance when the network is functioning normally. The Universal Group membership that is stored in the domain controller may become out of date as the group membership is changed. For this reason, once Universal Group membership is stored on the domain controller, it will be updated every 8 hours. All you need to remember is that once Universal Group membership caching is enabled, the user is only required to authenticate using the domain controller once for the Universal Group membership to be cached. I will change to my domain controller to look at how to enable Universal Group membership caching. To configure Universal membership caching, open Active Directory Sites and Services from the Start menu. From Sites and Services, expand down until you get to the site that you want to enable Universal Group caching on, in this case, London. In the site container, notice NTDS site settings. You need to ensure that you modify the NTDS site settings under the site you want to configure. There are also NTDS settings under servers, but these apply to the domain controller. Universal group caching can only be set at the site level. You will not find the option in the NTDS settings for a domain controller. To access the settings, right-click NTDS Site Settings and select Properties. From here, it is a simple matter to tick the tick box Enable Universal Group Membership Caching. Once ticked, Universal Group Membership Caching will be enabled for all domain controllers in that site if you have more than one domain controller at that site. Notice the pull-down Refresh Cache form. The default option will refresh the cache from the closest global catalog server from that site. You could also select the same site. You would only do this if you had a global catalog server and a domain controller at the same site and you want to ensure replication only occurred locally from that global catalog server. Why would you do that? Perhaps the domain controller is on old hardware, and it was decided to reduce the load on the domain controller by not making it a global catalog server. On this network, there may also be another domain controller acting as a global catalog server. If the global catalog server was down, the other domain controller could authenticate users using the universal cache. If the global catalog was only expected to be down for short periods of time, the decision may be made to only allow replication from the local site. This is an unusual scenario, but Windows supports it if you wanted to configure it that way. To review what we have covered, a domain controller that is not a global catalog server can have universal membership caching enabled at the site level. Once enabled, the domain controller will cache universal group information on the domain controller indefinitely. In order for this to occur, the user needs to authenticate off that domain controller once. After this occurs, their universal group membership is stored on the domain controller and updated every 8 hours. The universal group membership cache is only used if a global catalog server is unavailable on the network. Enabling universal caching does not stop the domain controller from attempting to contact a global catalog server when a user authenticates. If a global catalog server cannot be contacted, then the universal group cached on the server is used. One more point to remember is that universal group caching only provides authentication. It does not replace the need to have a global catalog server. This means the user will still be able to log in, but will not be able to perform searches that require a global catalog server. For example, Active Directory queries could not be run, which software like Exchange relies quite heavily upon. Thanks for watching another free video from IT Free Training. In the next video, I will look at how contacts work in Active Directory. Contacts allow you to create a contact in Active Directory that is not a regular user. For example, if you had an external contractor that a lot of people used in the company, you could create a contact for that person. This would provide their contact details to the user in the domain without having to create a user account for that person.